Welcome back to Microbial Concepts. So this is another video related to taxonomy, and during your masters you have this topic that is polyphasic taxonomy. Okay, so these are my notes, and I hope if you get a question on polyphasic taxonomy, this is what you can write and you can score. Okay, so it is an approach that is based on multiple criteria to identify a newly discovered prokaryote. Okay, that is the polyphasic taxonomy, or it is a polyphasic approach. Now the term was coined by Colville and is used for the delineation of taxa at all levels. Okay, now identification is based on multiple criteria, that is phenotype, genotype and phylogenetic features. Now what are these terms? Now genotypic is genetic makeup of a cell that we study, okay, and which determines one of its character. That means the genetic makeup determines the one of the characters of your culture. Now phenotypic character, the observable characters of your microorganism resulting due to its genetic makeup. Now they are derived from protein and their functions and different chemotaxonomic markers and a wide range of other expressed features. That is phenotypic character or phenotypic approach. Phylogenetic approach is where we study everything related to the evolutionary development and the diversification of that particular microorganism. Okay, so that is how these terms, they are different from each other and they are used in the identification. Okay, now how a pure culture is identified by polyphasic approach. So this is the flowchart that I hope you will understand, and you can write this in your exam to score your marks. So you have, you say suppose you have a culture which is you need to identify, or that is new you guess. So how to proceed? So you get a pure bacterial isolate, then you do phenotypic methods, that is classical phenotypic analysis, that can be differentiated into morphological features, that is cellular, where you study the shape, whether the culture can produce endospore, whether it has flagella, any inclusion bodies, and you do gram staining. Then colonial morphological features are like the color of your colony, dimension and the form. Okay, then comes the physiological and biochemical features. In that you study growth at different temperatures, pH and salt concentration. Then growth in the presence of various substances such as antimicrobials, whether it is resistant to that or whether it is sensitive to a particular antimicrobial. Then presence or activity of various enzymes. That means the enzyme system of that particular isolate has to be studied, and then comes the metabolism study. Okay, after that, automated systems. Okay, that means the phenotypic test, they are performed and results are interpreted. This is on an automated system. This is you do on your own. Okay, you by doing some biochemical test and by observing the morphological features. Now determination of cell wall composition, that is important, that is the traditionally in gram positive bacteria, that is also done on an automated system. Then cellular fatty acids, they are studied. So there are polar lipids, that is they are studied frequently for the classification and identification purpose. Okay, then the FAME analysis, that is fatty acid methyl esters. The profile is made. Okay, they are all everything is done on an automated system. Okay, the sample is loaded, there are the special instruments, and on that the profiles of, say now if you are studying with the FAME, okay, you want to study the FAME profile of your culture, then there is a FAME machine or instrument which is used to get the reports. Okay, so after doing FAME, you go for isoprenoide quinones, the large variability of site change, okay, characterizes the bacteria at different taxonomic levels. The two major structural groups are naphthoquinones and benzoquinones, and a whole protein analysis. This is done. After that, polyamines. Now polyamine patterning, that is used to trace relatedness at and above the genus level and a species level. Okay, so again a polyamines or the polyamine patterning is done. So this was everything about phenotypic approach or phenotypic methods. Now after doing this, we proceed for genotypic methods, that is gene related techniques. We use them for identification. So first comes the DNA sequencing, then there is rRNA gene sequencing, that is 16S rRNA. Okay, so let's go with the DNA sequencing. So determination of DNA base ratio, that is the percent of GC content, is studied. Now the range observed is, say if it is below 3%, then it is within a well-defined species, and if it is less than 10%, then it is within a well-defined genus. That is how, depending on a DNA base ratio, the identification can be done. Now DNA-DNA hybridization and tDNA-PCR, these are the other techniques that are used for the identification till the species level. Okay, now actinobacteria is also referred to as high GC content gram positive bacteria, and Firmicutes, they are referred to as low GC content gram positive bacteria. Okay, so this is how the DNA base ratio, they are, or this is the reason why they are important in the genotypic methods, and they help in identification. Okay, so after doing the DNA-DNA hybridization and tDNA-PCR, you move further for DNA amplification techniques. So a video is uploaded for RAPD AFLP on my video. You can, on my channel, you can check out those video if you don't know about these amplification techniques. Now AFLP is amplified fragment length polymorphism. RFLP is also one of it, and it identifies species strain level, and it is used for typing purpose. Now ARDRA, that is amplified rDNA restriction analysis, it is done for species specific patterns. Okay, to study species specific patterns. Then RAPD, that is random amplified polymorphic DNA. Then APPCR, that is genotypic study using arbitrary primers. Then REP PCR, that is repetitive sequence based PCR, that is again done for strain typing. Then DAF, that is DNA amplified fingerprinting. Okay, so these are the DNA amplification techniques which are used for identification of the species and strain level. Okay, so after DNA amplification techniques, you go for ribotyping, that is you study RNA. Okay, so tRNA as probe, they are used for identification for the strain level. Then low frequency resistant fragment analysis, that is LFRFA, and restriction length, restriction fragment length polymorphism, that is RFLP, they are also used. Then you go for low molecular weight RNA profiling methods, that is tRNA fractions and rRNA fractions. Okay, and that is the phenotypic typing methods. They characterize strain at intraspecific levels, that is within species. If the characterization has to be done, then that is also done. Example, serotyping and biotyping are the methods. Okay, so I hope you like my video. Do share my videos with your friends and do subscribe to my channel. And thank you.